Hello. Sad. They are dead. I wonder if anybody knows why this could happen. Is it because A, of a meteorite impact? Or C, because of kind of super volcano that exploded? Or C, not enough food? Anybody knows? A, B, C?
A.
C, of course, not enough food, thank you. Will this happen also with us, human beings? I don't think so. I think if you see this chart, the growth of the human population is going quite up. It was quite stable until the last millennium. And then we go 3 billion. Now we share our space with more than 6 billion people. And we go up, the drain goes up to the 9 or 10 billion people. I wonder if it's possible to produce food by then. The problem is that producing food is not easy. Normally, in the land, we grow horizontal. But if we want to live in the city, that's also one of my concerns, you have to produce more vertically, go up. This is one of the first vertical farming projects that I know. It's like 600 years before Christ. It was a king who designed and built a garden for his wife. It is the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, the first vertical farming project ever. Nowadays, architects design futuristic buildings where they integrate living, working, and production of food in one ecosystem. Will our future look like this? I think it might be happening, but not until now, because urban farming projects are quite successful. I visited some in Shanghai, in New York, and all I see is some rooftop farming or recovery of lost spaces, where some of the happy few can produce some veggies. But it will be unable to produce food for large masses of humans who are hungry. So there need to be another solution. Urban farming, I think it's the future, but there are no solutions. It's technically not feasible yet. But I became inspired. And I think I found a solution, and I'd like to share it with you. What you see here is the jungle, or the rainforest in Venezuela. As you know, I lived there for quite a while, and the rainforest also inspires me. I think the rainforest is how the world began, some billion years ago. Plants, they develop in a quite misty environment. They grow, and they produce many secrets that we still don't know. Many medicines, for example, they come from the Amazons. I think it could happen also with the food. One of the things in Amazon that I think is very special are orchids. I'm not a flower expert, but if you see, an orchid does not have the roots in the soil. The roots are just in the air. An orchid hangs and grows. How is it possible? In a misty environment, the orchid is able, thanks to many years of evolution, to get nutrients and water out of the air, out of the misty environment. And I wonder if it's possible also with other vegetables or fruits or herbs. For example, can I put a lettuce in the air and just let it grow? Or a strawberry or some herbs? And I think it's possible. Time for testing. I went to Venlo in the Floriade. I rented a small space in a greenhouse. And we start with some tests to see if it's possible to grow vegetables in the air. So I made some vertical pots, bought some machines, some vaporizers, and contracted a professional farmer, because I'm not a farmer, to help me out with the production of the first batch of lettuces. And as you can see in the picture, it works. The roots grow out. They just develop themselves inside the columns. They think that they are an orchid. But then I tasted them, and I didn't like them so much because they looked nice, the weight was good, everything went well, but when I tasted them, and now it's just if I'm eating some water, I don't know, I don't like it. But I decided to hire another expert who's very famous worldwide about testing. In this case, it is animal testing. This is Dr. Fluffy. It's very expensive, but okay. Animal testing is not the correct word, I think. I think we should say animal tasting. Because animals have the sixth sense that we don't have. A rabbit, for example, if he smells the lettuce, his body, his sixth sense, or his gut feeling, tells him, hey, this is good for me, I can have it. We humans have lost that. We just put some dressing or some salt and we eat it and I don't care. But he can die. So I provided him the lettuces from the pot and some lettuces that are grown in the soil as baseline. And he didn't eat my lettuce. He just hopped, pop, 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 to the lettuce that are grown in the soil. And he ate it. And I said, why? Why, Dr. Fluffy, what did I do wrong? Help me out, what is the missing link? And when he finished his meal, he said, Lawrence, my friend, the missing link is called full spectrum. And that needs some explanation. Full spectrum, many people can claim that they hear the difference between vinyl music or CD music. And the full spectrum. I think it's clear, you can hear the difference. Not only for sound, but also for light. There's a full spectrum of light plants need. They are growers. They say, we can imitate the sunlight and just use the LED lamps, blue, for example, or red. But at the fact, you need the full spectrum of light, like this. So plants can grow. But not only with light, a plant also needs a full spectrum of nutrients. Okay, how can a plant become healthy if the grower only provides, they call it, the essential nutrients? Five or six, you can see it. A plant, a tomato for example, needs at least 60 different nutrients to become healthy. And healthy means nutritional for us. It's not possible that the plant can be healthy for us if we don't provide it with a complete scheme of nutrients. Not only the elements, also talking about phytonutrients, alkyds, acids, everything a plant can find in the virgin soil. This is me in Venezuela drinking some water. I need it now for my throat, but anyway. The complete spectrum of light, the complete spectrum of nutrients in a good environment is the only way we can produce healthy food. So it was testing again. I made some changes in the setup. I changed the chemical fertilizers for biological fertilizers. And I added some nutrients that I make an extract. It's like a stimulator I extract from the Amazon River and the sea. Together with this complete nutritional spectrum, I was able to produce quite good lettuces. It was very healthy lettuces, it was a good yield, and you can ask that to, for example, Dr. Fluffy, who gained a kilo or something. Afterwards, I came to the conclusion that at this moment, if we can manage to grow in a messy environment in cities and we can produce healthy, affordable food, then it's time to bring the farm to the city. Okay, this vertical farming will be our future farming. Future farming, I call it full spectrum farming. Thank you and excuses for the slide. Thank you very much.